I'm Anthony, I'm from Indonesia. So I'm currently doing my PhD at UNSW in School of Social Sciences. The first time I met Eban was in Indonesia because at the time my organization, local DPO in Padang, so we applied for a volunteer from Australian Volunteer International.
I had absolutely no idea what to expect. I'd worked as a support worker with people with disabilities before, but I'd never worked in any kind of context like Anton's organization worked in.
I've got some information about Eban, about his background, about his experience working with people with disability. We talked about what my organization did, and then you told me you might not have the knowledge that my organization wanted, but it turned out Eban's knowledge was like, you know, very big strength to my organization.
I've known Anton now for, I think, 5 years. My esteem of Anton, my appreciation of Anton, I think has been really, really steady all the way through.
I can't really see any change apart from, I think, like, steady friendship. Like, he still treats me like a brother and also still treats him like a brother.
Anton's whole family really brought me into their family. I really felt like I was a son to Anton's mum and a friend to Anton's wife and a son to Anton's dad.
I want him to be like friends, you know. So that's why I helped him to find a place of stay close to my house. So we're living in the same living compound. And since then, Eban has been like a frequent visitor to my home. I mean, like, so my mom even treats him like her own son, you know.
Getting to know a new culture is like getting to know an iceberg. What you see is a tiny little bit on top, which is people's behaviour, but what's actually happening is all of the values and all of the things that underpin people's behaviour. In Anton, I really felt like I had somebody that I trusted, who you can ask for advice or you can ask for feedback about, hey, what's this thing in this culture? People wanted to know where I was from, or would ask me questions. You know, where are you from? Are you married?
You have children.
Do you have children? And sometimes those questions felt too personal. You know, that's not necessarily part of our culture. But it was also very, very welcoming. You know, people genuinely wanted to get to know things about me.
Australia. People just mind their own businesses, you know? That was my first impression when I was in Australia. So I was a bit afraid to make friends with Australians.
You know, I think that what Anton just talked about in Australians being very independent, we can all be very independent, and that's really wonderful. But sometimes we're so independent that we forget to connect with other people. And we forget that, you know, by connecting with other people, it opens up your world.